Welcome to the lecture video Basic Electronics. Today we will explain the conductivity of a semiconductor material. Now, if we apply an electric field E to the any semiconductor material or any material, then we will see the charge carrier of the material will be accelerated. So, for a semiconductor material, actually this one is bipolar. Why? Because the current drawn from the semiconductor material is drawn by both the charge carrier, that is from electron as well as from hole. So, if we apply the electric field E to any semiconductor material, then the charge carrier, that is electron and hole, that they will be accelerated. And by this, they will gain a velocity, and with that they will move. And the velocity is called drift velocity, and the value of drift velocity Vd is equals to mu into E. Basically, Vd is proportional to electric field. More electric field you will give, more velocity of the charge carrier. Now, this one is Vd is equals to mu into E. Now, what is mu? Mu is the mobility. Now, mobility is a parameter by which we can know, we can understand how fast a particle will move. Basically, in case of semiconductor, two type of charge carrier are there, one is electron and another one is hole. So, what will be the mobility for electron and hole? Are they same or are they not? Basically, the mobility is inversely proportional to the mass of the particle. And as we all know that the mass of electron is very less than the mass of hole. So, obviously, the mobility of electron will be, so mobility of electron say mu n, which will be much more greater than the mobility of holes. So, this is all about mobility and drift velocity. Now, if we concentrate and if we study a semiconductor material, suppose is there, and if we apply electric field E, then the current from this semiconductor material will be calculated, and then the equation I is equals to NQ A multiplied by Vd. Now, what is N? N is a total concentration of the charge carrier. That means how much charge carrier are present in the semiconductor material. Next, Q. Q is the charge of the semiconductor material. Next, A is the area of the semiconductor material, and Vd is the drift velocity. And as we know, the current density is defined by J, which is equals to I, the total current I divided by the area. So, the current density is equals to N Q Vd. This one will be Q N Q Vd. Now, what is the value of Vd? We know the value of Vd, which is equals to mu into E. So, we will place the value of Vd, that is equals to N Q mu into E. Now, together the product of carrier concentration with the charge and the mobility, we call this product by sigma, that is the conductivity of a semiconductor material. So, conductivity of a semiconductor material defined by sigma, which is equals to charge, that is Q, mobility, and with that carrier concentration N. Now, for a semiconductor material, there may be electron, there may be hole, both the charge carrier may present. So, if I consider that in a semiconductor material, total electrons, that electron concentration is N and hole concentration is P, then we can write, instead of writing this equation, we can write N multiplied by mu N. Why mu N? Because mu N is the mobility of the electron and N is the electron concentration, plus mobility of hole multiplied by hole concentration, with that Q into E, that means charge multiplied by electric field E. So, this is the conductivity of the semiconductor material, and this is the current density of a semiconductor material. Now, suppose for N type semiconductor material, we know that the value of N is much more greater than P. For N type semiconductor, electron concentration is much more greater than the hole concentration. So, for N type semiconductor, we can write this equation. For N type semiconductor, the value of sigma, which actually is N plus P charge into mu. Achha, can you cut this? Hello, last 2 minute cut kar dena. Actually, equation mein